Yep, there's a wee pluck. I've come out here today, just not very far from the road, just a quick jog, because I only have a wee while, a couple hours this afternoon. And this will probably be the last video in quite a while again. I'm not doing so many this year, just, you know, it's the way it goes. And so I thought I'd come out to here, enjoy the day out, make the best of it. And it's not a bad day again for trout fishing. This part of this loch, I've had like really good catches of fish just here, but not so much in recent years when I seem to do better up the far end of the loch. So I don't know what explains that. But the first day she almost be obeyed, wanted to go fishing. She came here with her spinning rod. I know I should 10 fish in 10 minutes, and they were good quality wee fish too, you know. Nothing huge, but up to maybe a pound, you know. She was just reeling them in. And she concluded that this fishing business was pretty easy and couldn't understand why some days I would come back with nothing, you know. I've started out on, again, one of John McLean's Clan Chief variations on the top, quite small, and a Digby's Demon on the point. And I haven't fished this loch much. I used to come here, not regularly, but quite regularly, you know, a few times a year, every year, but I haven't been really a regular attender this last few years. Be interesting to see how we get on. There's been a few changes, that's for sure. Because this might be the last day of fish in a while, you know, I want to try and concentrate mostly on, you know, drinking tea and stuff like that. I don't have any bananas with me though. Somewhat an oversight on my part. But I'll have the big bun there. No, I don't even have the big bun. I'll have something to go with the tea, I'm sure. Usually there's a few fish in this wee bay just ahead of me, you know, smaller fish usually. You know the way you get the weir dobblers, but I'm surprised I haven't even moved something along here. Most unusual. But again, it's a while since I've fished here and maybe the loch has changed, you know. Nah, that was a fish. It's a decent pull. But he wasn't for staying. So I'm going to have a change of flies. Amazing how they can give you such a decent pull and you not hook them. I don't know how they manage that. Sometimes I wonder if it isn't because they got like tangled in the line or something and they didn't touch the fly at all. I really don't know. So there I'm hooking up my line. Well, I hook a fish. These reel lines are bad for that sort of tangling in themselves and whatnot. They're odd lines. There we go. And looks to be about the size of fish I was expecting here. So they used to be a size bigger, but that's okay. And as you can see on the Digby's Demon, back he goes. We'll see where I ended up. So just in the last few minutes we've had a pool and landed a wee fish, sort of. So that's good. Right, a few more wee casts into this corner and then I'll move along, I think. And I can always fish this on the way back. I have to come back along this bank as well. Didn't do very well on it there. As I was saying, it's the sort of bit of bank that it wouldn't have surprised me if I'd had 10 or 12 fish off it. Though I have had days when I've had nothing, you know, but today looks like a day when you're in with a chance, you know. Decent wave, bit of cloud cover. As well as changing point, I changed flies. I've got, again, flies tied by John McLean, what I can only describe as a ridiculously red sedge hog. I'm sure there's probably a correct name for it, and I'm sure John could keep me right in those things. And one of his fantastic Connemara blacks tied as a bob fly, basically, on the point there. They have done really well for me, and I've had a lot of fish on them, so I've become a big fan. I'll just keep chopping and changing it with the flies to see if I can't hit some sort of magic formula, you know. Maybe I can't. That moved the fish. Oh well. Well, I've come along a bit and I've put on like a green fly on the top. Now I don't know what it is. It's like a green Invictus sort of fly. Dropped that one as well, as you can see. And maybe it started moving fish for me. Don't know, because I don't seem to have cracked it yet, but Oh, let's get the fingers crossed. So if the green Invicti kind of fly on the top, and the Connemara Black still on the point. There is behind me a sign. See, now I'm not a huge distance from the road, but it's a 20 minute walk from the road to here. And this is the village water supply. So someone, that moved a fish as well. Maybe this green fly is the boy to have, you know? Anyway, yeah, so someone with a book or something has decided that what the village and the water supply need is a sign, you see there, warning you that if you hold your head onto the water, you might die. Now, I absolutely get that people come out here and could have an accident, but the sign doesn't prevent the accident. What the sign tells you is that basically holding your head onto the water is not a good idea. And I'm fundamentally opposed to this sort of thing, because if, to be frank, you are that stupid, you should be encouraged to hold your head onto the water on the basis that it's good for society as a whole. Different matter. Somebody comes out here wearing a sheep, slip and fall or something. That's not the same thing at all. These people know what the risks are and do their best to avoid them. It's the people who don't understand that water in large quantities is dangerous. You need to be a special kind of stupid. So a lot of wee flurry of activity there to that sort of greeny coloured fly, I think. The flurry has been short-lived, so maybe only was one fish that took a sudden liking to it and splashed about a bit. And obviously I failed to land it. Not a very good performance on my part. I've got the cup of tea in the go, and one of these wee pepperami bars or something. I don't know. It's like a wee bit of meat in a stick. And I thought, oh, I'll have that boy, you know. As you maybe saw, I lost my green fly and a trout. I didn't quite realise I'd lost it, but the wee fish must have broke off my fly. Probably I tied a bad knot, that's usually the reason why. And now I've got an aeroplane somewhere. Can't see it, but I've got an aeroplane somewhere. And I'm gonna have my cup of tea and see how I progress, you know? Because it's like a great day for trout fishing and I'm not catching any trout. So I'm struggling to get a fly or something that works. That green fly moved a couple of fish before I lost it, and that fish that seemed to break off on it, you know? So I've put the green fly, I've got a few of them, I've put another one back on. And I've put something else in the point. I can't remember what. No, I still can't remember what. I'm going to give them another bash out there. Because, you know, it's a nice warm wind, good waves, good overcast day. I can't think of a single thing not to like about all this, you know. And quite frankly, most days I go out, I kind of catch the fish I expect to catch. So some days I go to really dour lochs and I catch nothing or one fish or something like that, and it's what I expect. But today I thought I might come here and get 20 fish for a quick afternoon, you know. And in actual fact, I've had one, and well, I lost that one that I presume broke me off, and I've had a few other wee plucks and grabs, but nothing that counts as catching fish, you know. So it's not gone well for me. Maybe I'm no good at it, you know. In a strange way, I wouldn't like to be good at it, in the sense that I come out for the day out, and being good at it kind of implies taking it seriously, you know. That's the last thing I want to do. So, cup of tea, we'll give it another go in a minute or two. Maybe move around the corner a wee bit as well. See how that goes. But disappointingly few fish, I would say. I don't think I'm doing very well. I had my wee cup of tea. And as I was saying during my wee cup of tea, I changed flies. So I put the, or kept the green thing on. I think the fish broke off my green thing because I lost it. I'm pretty certain I broke it off in that fish, unfortunately. But it must just have been a bad knot. I mean, I was fishing pretty light nylon. So it could just have been a bad knot. So I have the green, like a green bumbly sort of thing on the top, and a Watson's fancy bumble kind of fly on the point, a bit of green, a bit of red, you know, sort of some variation colours there. And I'll just give this another wee cast and then I'll move on a bit. Here, walk around the dangerous sign. See, very dangerous looking sign. And then we'll cast out here, maybe. The interesting thing about the dangerous sign is that somebody probably had to come out in a quad bike out here and put it up, which means they probably had to do some sort of risk assessment for putting up the sign. So the actual putting up of the sign, in view of the fact that pretty much nobody is ever going to see the sign, because I mean there's very few people out here, the only people out here will be the very occasional angler, and I mean, when I say very occasional, I mean maybe one a year, you know, the very occasional angler and people working at sheep. And people working at sheep are already well appraised of the fact that when you hold your head under the water, it's dangerous. And they do their best to avoid accidents if they can, you know. So they don't need the sign. And anglers, I'd imagine most people who can tie a knot also don't need a sign telling them that, you know, the world is a dangerous place, especially if you hold your head under the water. So I don't know who the sign's for, really, you know. I've moved along a wee bit further and try another few wee casts out here. see if I can't move anything. I'm still on the sort of green bumbly type thing, Invicta bumbly type thing. I don't know what you'd describe it as. Don't know what it's called. And like a Watson's Fancy Bumble as well. See, I can't get them to move anything. The wind around here, it's a bit exposed around here, and it's a bit more gusty and changeable. And it's one of these lochs with the wee hills and whatnot around it that you tend to get, like, that the wind can blow in five different directions at once. It can be a bit of a nuisance, to be honest. It's just one of those lochs. It's like that, you know. So, I think I'm going to move along a wee bit. The next step that I want to move to requires quite a lot of walking. Although it's not very far, the shape of the loch means I have to walk around bits, which requires quite a bit of walking. We fish on the Watson's Fancy Bumble sort of thing. There we fish. Oh. Well, he's putting up an awfully good fight now. There we go. Away he goes. I'm surprised at how few fish are moving. Yeah, so I'm going to walk around. There's like a channel, and I'm going to try and walk around it and try from the other side of it, because there are always fish in the channel. It's a matter of getting in there, basically. But it's quite a walk around because of the shape of the loch. Aye. Again, another wee fish, just about the size I sort of expect in here now. And that one came on the sort of the green thing, the name of which I don't know. So, you go so long, no sign of fish, and then in a couple of casts, you get two fish and you wonder, how does this happen, you know? Have they just come on? Or is it just pure luck? The other thing today is I'm seeing very few insects about. Now, I suspect part of that is because the conditions the way they are, most stuff's hatching at night, or pretty much at night. There doesn't be much darkness anyhow, but, you know, stuff's hatching well into the what darkness there is. just makes sense, and the fish are feeding then, really. I'm guessing that's why there's not much about during the day, you know. Somewhere I was fishing the other day and the rocks were all white. They'd obviously been like that canis sort of patch during the night, during the evening previous. Fish, and another one on the green thing, like a green bumble. And get your tail out of there. Off he goes. So you see, I've had what, 3 fish on a pool in the last 3 or 4 minutes, and that's kind of what you expect this loch to fish like. On a day like this, just fish after fish, you know. So I'm surprised that it has been so slow. Right, I'm going to start walking around a wee bit. If it takes my fancy, I can fish this bit on the way back again. Well, for some reason, all the clegs, horseflies, have started to attack me here. Don't know why here. I haven't seen them all day. Oh, now that was a good wee tug. This wee channel here is usually full of fish. But because of the way the hills channel the wind, it can be a hard wee spot to fish because the wind's on my right shoulder. It's very rarely you get the wind right for it, you know. But I'll give it a wee throw. These clegs are starting to annoy me. I'll maybe go for the midge repellent, the acaridin, because it also keeps them off. It doesn't make them go away, but they land on you and they just pick up and leave again immediately. So it's great for them. So I might have a wee scoosh of it if they're going to keep coming. I don't know where they came from because I haven't seen any all day, and then all of a sudden when I stood here, they just descended on me. Weed. Didn't feel like a fish. Now I'm hooked on these weeds with my line. Tangle off occasion. There's a lot of it going on. Hitting something behind me. Yeah, maybe my camera even. just because the wind's a wee bit awkward across this. Oh, that moved a wee fish, but didn't hook him. I did touch. Oh, must have came again. He's on the Watson's fancy bumble type fly. Oh, that's me, the same wee fish rising, that give me the wee pluck. Here we go. We trout. It's on like the green bumbly thing this time. So I think it's getting about time to start walking back, if not quite, you know. I may have a wee cast or two along the way, but I think it's getting time for me to be pretty much done for the day, you know? And I've had a few fish, but nothing like the numbers that I thought was the potential for, and most of them not from the places that I imagined they would come from either, which is strange. However, the fish do this on you every day, don't they? That's part of the fun. They do something different to keep you on your toes. This is the bit of bank where I started out from, and I just thought I'll have a quick cast on it on the way back, just break up the walk, and also to see if I can move anything off it now, you know, because I didn't do anything off it earlier. I think maybe I had one fish, can't remember, but it's like, so I'm just giving it a wee belt, just as the last few casts. So pretty much I think that'll do me. I kind of have this feeling that I want to go home and get some FOD, you know? And with the bright sun having just come out, I also kind of feel like maybe I have had the best part of the day in fishing terms, you know, while I had the cloud. That's maybe a thing as well, you know. few wee bits of cloud floating about, but not much, you know. So I think I'll call that done for the day, and that's probably the video's done for quite some time now. I don't know. My movements are hard to predict. So don't know when I'll be back, but it was a great day out. Very strange. I mean, a lack of fish. I did have a few, but you know, a lack of fish compared to what you might expect, in that I maybe had, I don't know how many fish I had, 5, 8 maybe, whereas I might have expected, you know, 20 or 30. Just the way it goes. So hopefully it won't be too long until the next video, and hopefully maybe it'll be back in the Hebrides, but I don't really know these things. But in the meantime, that's me calling it quits for today.